So it's time to start solids with your little one. Well, here's everything that we used that maybe you may find useful as well. Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you items that you may find useful when starting solids with your little one. These are items that we use and still continue to use as we move along in our process to introducing different foods to our little one. So let's get into those items. We started solids a few months ago, and one thing that I have learned about this process is babies will do what they want. Sometimes you give them a food that you think they're absolutely gonna love, but they don't really care for. And then sometimes you give them something that you think they're not gonna like at all, but they end up really loving. So you just have to keep trying and trying, and eventually they're gonna get it. So if you give them something today or tomorrow or the next day and they don't like it, just keep trying, because eventually they're gonna end up liking it. And one thing that I've also realized is that just because you don't like certain food items, for example, you don't like mangoes or broccoli, so go ahead and give it to your babies, because you want to develop their palate so they can be good eaters. So just because I don't like peas doesn't mean I'm not gonna give it to my little one. You have to have a lot of patience, because eventually they're gonna get it, and make it fun along the way as much as possible. So let's get into those items that we use. The first thing you need is a high chair. Now there's so many different high chairs on the market in so many different price ranges. So this one really depends on your budget and what you like. We went with the IKEA high chair. It's only $20. It's very simple, straight to the point, very easy to clean. It doesn't take up a lot of space, and I don't really have to worry about it getting messed up too much, because again, it's inexpensive. And what I did was I customized it a little bit. So I added some contact paper on the legs to make it look like it's wooden legs. And then I also added footrest. I read somewhere that having a footrest on a high chair for kids is really important, because it makes them very comfortable when they're eating. So I ended up finding this one on Etsy and added it to the chair. And then I also added a silicone mat onto the tray. That way, when she's done eating, I can just pick up the mat, bring it to the sink, wash it, and the high chair will always remain clean. So these are just some few things that I did that made it look a little bit more like it's expensive and a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. So yeah, I really like the IKEA high chair. If you don't have the space for a high chair, booster seat is also a way to go. We have the Bumbo booster seat, which we tend to use sometimes, but not as much as the IKEA one. So again, there's so many different options out there. Just kind of take a look at what works in your space and your budget and your style, and go with that for the baby. One thing that you may also need that I personally don't have is a splatter mat. Now this one, I went back and forth debating whether or not I wanted to get it, but I didn't find that I absolutely had to have it. Babies already come with so many things. You have to buy so many things for baby that I didn't want to buy something that I don't absolutely need. I have a small home and my space is very limited, so if I don't need it or I'm not gonna use it a lot, then I'm probably not gonna get it. But if you have a home where you think a splatter mat might work in, maybe you want to protect your floors, or where your high chair is located, it's on a carpet or a rug that you want to protect, then I highly suggest you go with a splatter mat, because when babies eat, they make so much mess. That way everything can fall onto the mat and then you can easily wipe it off. I have hardwood floors all throughout my home and I'm always cleaning, so I don't really mind cleaning after she's done eating. I didn't find this one a necessity, but again, it all depends on the space that you have. The next items you're gonna need are beeps, and for this one you're gonna need a few different ones. So I'm gonna show you some of the ones that we have. First, we have this one here. It's a silicone beep, and then it has like a pocket here so that everything that she drops will fall right in here. I really like this. This is probably my favorite beep. It's large that it covers a big enough space that they don't get their clothes messy. But when we are eating something that I know is going to be messy no matter what, then I would go with this bib. This is just one of those ones that you wear. So we put this on and then we tie it in the back, and that way no matter what mess, it just stays on the beep and it doesn't go in her clothes. Because even though you're gonna end up washing the clothes afterwards, sometimes the stains are hard to get off. So if you can put it on something like this that is easy to wash, it's always a plus. So we have this, and then we also have this for those meals that don't make a whole lot of mess, maybe like oatmeal or whatnot. This one is also useful, and also I like to carry this in the diaper bag sometimes. This one also has a pocket that food can fall in, but I think the pocket is pretty useless because it always stays flat, so nothing is really getting caught in there. But yeah, this is also good to have for those meals that you're not gonna cause a whole lot of mess with. These are all plastic materials, so it's easy to clean and wash. If you're gonna stir solids, you definitely need a few of these. The next item I'm gonna show you is this pacifier feeder. You've probably already seen this before, but basically you get a few of these when you purchase it in different sizes. These are the strainers that you, I'll show you. You just kind of put this through here like this. And then you can put whatever food you want in there, and then you're just gonna close it off like so. And then give it to the baby and they can nibble on this. This also works really well as a teething toy. You can put like cold blueberries or strawberries or bananas in here and give this to baby. This is how we really started our whole solid journey. Whenever we're eating something, maybe like avocado or banana or strawberries, whatever it is, I just kind of put a little bit in here and I give it to her, and she just kind of like to play around just to get a taste of the different types of food. So this is how we started, and she still uses this. Like I said, it can act as a teething toy. I got this particular one on Amazon. It came in this pink color. Also, like I said, it came with a few of these in different sizes. And then it also came in a blue color. All these were in one pack, and then it came with this cover so that when you put food in there, you can just kind of close it off like this to store it a little bit more better. So yeah, I really like this. If you're starting to introduce, we started using this I think when she was 4 months, again, to start introducing solids to her little by little. But of course, talk to your pediatrician or your doctor to make sure you're doing the right thing. But I started with very simple foods like avocados and bananas and strawberries that I would just put in here, and she really, really likes it. I talked about the Komotomo bottles in my newborn essential videos, and I even mentioned it briefly in my What's in My Diaper Bag video. But this is what a regular Komotomo bottle looks like. And I think I mentioned in that video that you can convert these into sippy cups. So this is what it looks like once it's converted into a sippy cup. So like you can see the top, it's now a complete sippy cup that the baby can use. And then I also have the straw version. So when you buy it, it comes in this little container, and then you get the nipple. This is the straw version. And then the little tube that you connect in here and then attach to the bottle so the baby can drink from. I find that this is really, really good for transitioning into sippy cups and straw cups in general. I find that this is really good to have to transition babies from regular feeding bottles to sippy cups and straw cups, because these, you know how when we're drinking from straws, when we pull through a straw and you stop pulling, the drink kind of goes back into the cup or the bottle. Well, this doesn't do that. Whenever she pulls from this, whenever she stops pulling, the liquid kind of remains where it is. It doesn't go back into the bottle, so that when she comes back to pull again, she can continue from where she left off. So it's not too exhausting, and it's an easy way for them to practice using sippy cups. She really, really likes this a lot. So far, I've only used this for water. I want to use it for milk and see if she's gonna like it, but this tube is so tiny that I'm not sure how I'm gonna clean it once I start using it for milk. But yeah, this is good to have to transition from regular bottles into sippy cups. Another one that is also good to have if you want to also help them use regular cups, this one is a good one to have. It's really, really tiny, and the baby can hold it like this and practice using this for drinking. This is also one that I was very, very surprised how quick she learned how to use this. I thought it was gonna take a while before she figured out how to drink from an open cup, but this makes it so easy that she took to it really quickly. So this is also a good one to have to start helping them drink from open cups. Another good items to have for transitioning are these spoons. I think it's by the brand Ola Baby. This is the long one for when you are feeding the baby, and this is a shorter version for when they are feeding themselves, so they can practice feeding themselves with this one. And then when you are feeding them, you can use this one. They're silicone, so they're really soft. The actual spoon is really tiny. So again, this is a really good one to have for transitioning. She really, really likes using this. She likes to grab it from your hands when you're feeding her and try to feed herself with it. And it's also very easy for them to hold and grab. So yeah, this is also another good one for transitioning. And then I also have this spoon and fork, but this one I think you need more after they've transitioned and they're more comfortable using utensils themselves. Then you can give this to them. It's short, easy for them to grab. And then this little thing that it has here is so that they won't, you know, push everything down their throat. It kind of ends here on their mouth, so it doesn't go past this little area here. So this is really good to have once they're able to feed themselves. Then you can move on to something like this. You're gonna need bowls and containers to store food or to feed baby with. I went with these glass ones by the brand OXL. You can find these on Amazon, but I got mine from Marshall's. They're glass. They are 4 ounces. They are 4 ounces glass containers with really airtight lid. And then they have this silicone sleeve that you can remove, you know, when you have something a little bit hot in there. You can use the silicone sleeve. I use this to store food in the fridge. I also use this to feed her. It's microwave safe. So there's so many uses for this. I have about 8 of these, and we use this constantly. That way, when you're feeding her something and you don't finish it up or you want to store food, just have really easy containers to do that in. When I freeze her purees in the fridge a few hours before I feed it to her, or maybe if I plan on giving it to her the next day, I'll pop one in here and put it in the fridge so that by the time we're ready to use it, it has defrosted really well. And I also bring this with me when we're going out. I'll put purees in here and put it in our diaper bag. It's small enough, so you know, there's so many uses for these. You can put snacks and other food in here for the baby. So yeah, these are multi-use. If you can find them, get them. They're really good to have. And then I also have this bowl. I have to be honest, I haven't really used these yet, because again, I feel like this is when she's more comfortable feeding herself. Then I'm gonna start using this, but this is also good to have. It's big, so it can fit quite a bit in here. And then the bottom here, once it's a suction, so when you put it on the high chair, they can move it, it's not going anywhere. It also came with the plate with 3 compartments. Again, suction in the bottom, and then you can close it and store food in the fridge as well. I haven't started using this yet because, again, I will start using these when she's comfortable feeding herself. For now, we just kind of put everything on that silicone mat that we got for the IKEA high chair. And she eats from the silicone mat, but eventually we're going to transition into these. So these are good to have on hand. You're also going to need a food maker. My sister sent me a food maker she bought for my nephew and didn't use as much as she thought she would. So she mailed it to me, and she mailed it around the holidays when the post office were really, really busy. And I think the box broke and some of the parts went missing. So I was really bummed when I received it because I wasn't able to use it. But if you have the space in your kitchen, or if you are the kind of person that you think you're going to need a food maker for a baby, then go ahead and get a food maker. There's so many different ones. I'll insert a few on the screen so you can see what some of the options are. But there's so many on Amazon and different places that you can find them. They steam the food and you can blend them and make purees really, really easy. I'm really bummed I couldn't use mine, but so instead what I do, I bought this pan from Marshall's. I paid only $20 for this. I kind of go ahead and steam all her food in here, and then I would put it in my Ninja blender and blend it, and then we have the puree. Ninja came with a few different cups for blending smoothies, so I kind of saved the smaller cup just for her purees. Steam it in that silver pot, blend it, and then we're good to go. So this also really works well for those people that feel like they don't need food maker. Like I said, I had one that I couldn't use, but this works just as fine. And then when I blend it, I put it in here. This takes maybe 2 to 3 ounces of food per hole, and so I just kind of put the purees in here, and then I'll put it in the freezer. And when we're ready, it's silicone, so it's very easy for you to pop one out like this. It comes out very easily, and then you can pop one out when you're ready and then warm it up and feed her. But like I said, if I know I'm gonna give her something the next day, I put it in our glass containers so it can defrost by the time we're ready to use. So these are very, very good. I actually have two of these. I have another one in grates actually in the freezer right now. But yeah, these are very good to have. And when I'm done freezing the food in here, sometimes I'll put it in a silicone Ziploc bag such as this one and keep it in the freezer so that this is not taking up too much space. I'll just pop out all the frozen food and put it in here. So yeah, there's so many different ways to store food and freeze food for the baby. I have even frozen food in the glass containers that I showed you. So yeah, there's so many ways to store food for a baby. I'm going to leave a link to everything that I talked about down in the description box below. So make sure you check that. And if there is something that I didn't mention that you have found useful when introducing your little one to solids, please leave that in the comment section below for me, because I'm still learning and I'm still, you know, it's such a struggle doing this whole solid thing, and it's such a process. So if there's something that you use that you have found that made it a little easier for you, please leave that in the comment section for me to check out. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you back here in about a week for my next video. Bye.